Everything you see exists together in a delicate balance.
This was the one I identified as the one that I felt I could really do something special with.
Direction from last time, because we're changing what it's going to look like visually, because you're going to be at the top of a really high rock, and it's going to be wind blowing, and you're going to be really kind of scared.
What are we doing? There's nothing up here.
First of all, it's storyline, and just how impactful the message is that the movie just puts out there.
I think that I started watching the movie when I was about maybe 5 or 6. I can't really remember. But I definitely loved seeing it. And I was like, wow, I want to be young Nolan one day.
Yeah, I know. From my mic, I was like, I knew that he did it.
Yeah.
A couple years after that, then I got, you know, The Lion King on Broadway. And then a couple years after that, here I am today.
Mufasa and Simba are gone, which means I am your king.
These characters actually take you on extraordinary journeys and emotional journeys and very complicated journeys, you know. So, I mean, what's not to like about that in a way? You know, you just kind of go along for the ride of these films. And so bringing them back in this way, in a way that can actually be, in some ways, like more relatable, where you can really just sort of fall down the rabbit hole, you know, with these characters in this way, is pretty stunning.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. It ain't no passing phrase.
You know, it's a sad story in a way. It's definitely a moving story. It's not just this big splashy comedic animated musical the way we sometimes see. There's a lot of emotion in it, a lot of levels to it, and you know, I, along with Seth, get to be sort of the comic presence.
I was a young warthog!
It's not a traditional sound, but you bring so much.
I almost nailed it!
It was very unique.
90%!
It's so gratifying and amazing, and the idea of getting to like relive that story in a new way is really exciting, I think, as like someone who loves the movie. Like, it's exciting knowing that I get to watch another version of that movie.
Simba? Is that really you?
Yeah! Yeah, it's me, Simba! It's really me!
When I first heard John was doing it, I was very excited because I really liked the Jungle Book adaptation he did. He has a really good knack for updating things without changing them, really. I think that's really hard to do. Most people hate sequels. I understand, I'm one of those people. I don't like, it's not even changed, but I don't like it when things don't have a voice, you know? And sometimes the voice that's in it already is enough, but he really cares about the project and really wants to speak to it. And I think the message that this movie has is extremely relevant. And it's like the first one, where it's a different message, but they're both relevant all the time.
You must take your place in the circle of life.